إذا الأمجاد قد عظمت فللأمجاد بانيها، ومن يسعى إلى العليا سيدركها بما فيها، ويبني مجده جذلا فروح الفذ يعليها، ليصبح همة تروي عن العليا مغانيها.
Assalamu alaikum and welcome to another exciting episode of the ITV Math Show. I'm your host and presenter Mohammed Kota, and we're shooting here from our studios in Johannesburg, South Africa, here in Rivonia. Right, like to say warm welcome to all of you who have joined us, as well as our older viewers, right? Those in their 50s and 60s and 70s, as well as all our grade 11s and 12s who have been following our series from the beginning of the show right through until today. I don't even know how many episodes we've shot. We've probably shot about 30, 40 episodes. And for those of you who have opened up your ITV math file and you're following it and you're going through these sequences and these patterns and these topics religiously, right? I am confident from the emails that we've received as well as from all the blogs that it is having the desired impact that we intended when we started the show. Okay, so without any further delay, let's get started with today's show. Just to tell you exactly where we are at, we are in episode 4 of probability. Now, we started from grade 11 work, all the basics, and we probably will carry on today's show. There probably will be about 5 shows in with regard to probability. Now, today's episode deals with the grade 12 component of probability only. So grade 11s, you don't need to know what we are doing today. And it's a very interesting concept. It's a very interesting concept because no matter what industry you are in, whether you're in the banking industry, whether you're in the food industry, whether you are a housewife, even if you are in the sports industry, any industry, you would be able to utilize the tools and the techniques that we are about to show you today in order to calculate possible combinations, or what we call in mathematics or in probability, permutations. Okay, the word permutation. But we'll go through that as we go through the show. Let me explain to you, let's give you, as we always start from a topic, I start you off from ground zero. And ground zero is which are the two topics that are required for grade 12. So I'll give you a mind map, give you the overview, then we start going into hectic examples of each type. So now we've got the fundamental, the two major components of probability grade 12. Number one is the fundamental counting principle and factorials. Now, many of you in grade 12, you still don't know the difference between a fundamental counting principle and a factorial. So I've just put the definitions here, some very basic definitions to grant you understanding about this topic, and then we're going to go into examples of each type so that it will make the picture much clearer for you. The fundamental counting principle deals with the total number of possible outcomes. Okay, so if you want to find out what is the total number of possible outcomes from three events, events A, B, and C, very simple, or simply put, all we do, we multiply the possible number of outcomes from event A, possible number of outcomes from event B, and possible number of outcomes from event C, and we multiply it. So we say A times B times C. Okay? When we talk about factorials, we talk about an arrangement of different objects in a definite order. So giving you an example of that, in how many different ways can 10 books be arranged on a shelf? You've got a box of pencil colors, all different colors, right? Let's say 7, the colors of the rainbow. I hope you all know the colors of the rainbow: violet, indigo, verb, gyo. You guys remember that? Do you remember that? Verb, gyo. Verb, gyo. Right? Violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. Okay? These are the 7 colors of the rainbow. In how many different ways can these letters here be arranged in this word? In how many different combinations? So you could have a V, I, B, G, Y, O, R. You can have the I first. I, V, B, G, Y, O, R. You can have I, G, B, V, Y, O, R. You can have I, Y, B, G, V, R. You can have, there's a host of different combinations. But you want to know what is the exact number of different combinations that you could have. Now, this is a factorial. It is not the fundamental counting principles. It's not just your total number of possible outcomes. It's an arrangement of different objects in a definite order. There's a definite order. How many spaces are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's a definite order. How many different arrangements can these words be manipulated? Right? Doesn't have to make the word verb gyo. It can make anything, but as long as one each of these letters are used, how many different ways can you manipulate this? That is called a factorial. And we'll go into it in more detail when I'm explaining it to you. So let's start off with some basic examples on the fundamental counting principle. Okay, the fundamental counting principle, let's take one example, right? Let's look at you've got a combination lock. You know a bicycle padlock? Those combination ones, the ones where you spin the dials. How many different combinations? Now, you want to try and pick your friend's bicycle lock, right? Or you have locked your kitchen door or your house door with one of these combination locks where you've got to spin the dials. It's got three dials. Dial 1, dial 2, dial 3. You want to find out how many different combinations. Now, you forgot what is the combination or what is the code to that lock. You want to find out now what is the probability that you are going to get that code right. Now, many people go and they start spinning. And they'll spin the first and they spin the second. So they'll go 001, 002, 003, 004, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. So it'll go 000. Then they'll go 010, 020, 030, 040, right up till 090, 011. 012, 013, 0. Now, do you know your fingers are going to turn blue? Right? And you're not going to open up that lock. I mean, if there's a stroke of luck, right? A lightning bolt of luck, you might just get that combination on the first shot. Right? Or maybe after 1,000 shots. Now, you want to find out after how many shots, how many possible combinations are there on that lock? So, very simple. Very simple. On the first dial, how many numbers do you have? From 0. Remember, we're using 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So how many numbers do I have? 10 numbers. I've got 10 numbers. Now, with fundamental counting principle, with both of them, we do sampling with replacement. And we do sampling without replacement. So what does it mean? It means if I used a number here, with replacement means that I can use the same number here. So if I had a 1 year, I can have a 1 year and I can have a 1 year. That's called with replacement because I can use it the first, I can use it the second, I can use it the third. But if I said without replacement, how many different combinations can you have? We're going to do both of them to see what is the difference in the number of combinations that are possible outcomes that could be derived or achieved. Okay, so with replacement, you'll have 10 options here. You'll have another 10 options on this dial. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And you'll have a 9. And you'll have another 10 options on the last one. So you can see that the numbers are not going down to 1. Now listen to what I'm telling you very carefully. The numbers are not going down to 1. You've got 10 combinations, 10 alternatives, 10 alternatives. Right? 10 options, 10 options, 10 options. How many total options do you have? Very easy. What did I say? A, B, C. So it's 10 times 10 times 10, which is equal to 1,000. 10 times 10 is 100 times 10 is 1,000. You have 1,000 combinations. Exactly 1,000 different combinations. What is the probability that you are going to get the number that you are looking for? You know, our most famous three-digit number, 786. What is the probability that you are going to get the number 786, right, to open up the lock? Your probability of that, the probability of you getting 786 is equal to that event. That's the event. So the probability of the event, 786, is 1 out of 1,000, which now you can convert it to 0.001. Okay, that is the probability, the likelihood of you getting the combination right as a decimal or as a fraction attached to probability. 1 out of 1,000, or you've got a 0.001% chance of you getting it right. Okay, so that is Another example, right? Just before we go to ad break. We're about to cut for ad break. Let's go on to the next one. You go to the, for all our gamblers out there, this is an interesting combination. You go to a slot machine, right? You want to know that you put in a 5 rand in the machine, what is the likelihood of you hitting jackpot? And jackpot we'll call 777. 777. Okay, so let's go. You go to the slot machine. You know the slot machine has got three dials. Some slots have got three dials. Some slots, I'm not a gambler, I'm just assuming. I think that some slots have got three dials. Some of them have got four dials. Some of them have got five dials. Right? On the first dial, you guys laughing me in studio. I really don't know. Right? I haven't been into a casino before. But in any case, so we've got, we need to get 777. Right? We need to hit, and that is your jackpot. How many alternatives? So say, for example, you have 30 pictures here. You could have a cherry, you could have a joker, you could have a banana, you could have had an apple, pineapple, whatever. You've got 30 different pictures here. You've got 30 different pictures there. You've got 30 different pictures there. Right, boys and girls, brothers and sisters, we're about to go for an ad break, cut for a 3-minute ad break. Calculate. What is the probability of you hitting 777 with 1 5 rand in a slot machine in a casino? We'll give you the answer after the break. Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to our show. We have started here with probability grade 12, and I left you guys before the break with sampling with replacement. I told you that you went to a slot machine or you went to a casino and you put in a 5 rand coin in a slot machine. You want to calculate what is the probability that you are going to hit the jackpot. And the jackpot, we're now assuming, like I'm saying, it's just an assumption that there are 30 pictures. There could be 50 pictures. Some slot machines have got 50 pictures on each dial. So they could have 50 pictures, 50 pictures, 50 pictures. What we're taking now on 30 pictures. What is the probability? What is the probability that you are going to hit the jackpot 777 with one spin? With one spin. So what are we going to do here? Using the, this is fundamental counting principle. You've got 7 options. You've got 30 options here. You've got 30 options there. You've got 30 options there. You multiply the options. You have 27,000 different combinations. 30 times 30 is 900. 900 times 30 is 27,000. The probability of your event, PE, the probability of the event, and what is the event? You hitting the jackpot. The probability of you hitting the jackpot with one spin is 1 out of 27,000. Right, your chances of winning is 1 out of 27,000 different tries. So don't think that if you're going to put in a second coin, your chances is 2 out of 27. If you put in a third coin, it's 3. No, 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 no. Once you put in a coin and you spin it, your chance is 1 out of 27,000. Then it resets. You put in another coin, your chance again is 1 out of 27,000. So for all you gamblers out there, for all of those who are considering going to the slot machines tonight or this weekend or whatever the case may be, now you know why you're losing, right? Your chances are 1 out of 27,000. But what happens if you had 50 pictures? 50, 50, 50. So if you had 50 pictures, 50 times 50 times 50, it's 125,000. So 50 times 50 pictures times another 50 pictures, you have got 125,000 different combinations, and your probability of winning is 1 out of 125,000. Okay, so you do the math, you make your calculated decision, you make your educated, informed mathematical decision, and then you decide, is it worth it for me to go and take my whole month's salary and go and spend it on a slot machine? Choice is yours. Take your pick, right? You also now, let's do another example. You now want to calculate how many possible vehicles are on Gauteng roads. You want to calculate how many vehicles, moving vehicles, I'm talking including trucks, trailers, motor vehicles, motorcycles, everything. Now, let's assume, let us assume that the first three, you know, on the number plate, we can calculate our combinations on a number plate. Because we know each car or each vehicle has got a unique number plate. So if we can calculate how many number plates are issued, what's the total number of number plates in Gauteng? We're talking Gauteng province only, right? How many number plates are issued? We can then assume how many moving vehicles are on Gauteng roads. So we know our Gauteng number plate ends with GP. Gauteng province, gangster's paradise. So we're going 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So we're now going to assume that the first three letters of the alphabet and the last three are numbers. Let's assume that this is the only type of number plate that exists in Gauteng, where the first three are letters, the last three are numbers. Okay, now with letters, remember, we're now going to assume no vowels may be used. You cannot use vowels. A, E, I, O, U, no. Right? And we want with replacement. So basically, you can have B, 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 1, 1, 1. There we go. It's not a vowel. It's not a vowel. And it is with replacement. So if I use the B here, I can use a B here, I can use a B there. If I use the number 6, I can use the number 6, I can use the number 6. For many of our very crazy South African drivers, I think your number plate should be 666. But in any case, we got 111. We're using BBB 111. And I know you guys like the one ooh GP, like boo GP. Right, so you want to have BBB 000, baba boo GP. That's the number plate you want. You want to calculate how many possible number plates are there on Gauteng roads. And not only that, you want to know that if you go to the licensing office, what is the probability that you're going to get your initials and 000 GP as one of the number plates randomly. We're not saying strategic, not saying we're paying for it and they're going to cut it out and they're going to allocate a number. We're saying that if all those number plates were dumped in one big room, what is the probability that you close your eyes, you scratch within all those number plates, you pull the number plate out and that number plate is your initials, whatever your initials may be. Okay, everybody likes personalized number plates. Everybody wants their own initials on a number plate. So let's calculate how many different combinations are there. How many different number plates are there that can be issued? How many vehicles on Gauteng roads? Okay. We know that these are letters. How many letters are there in the alphabet? 26. Right. We're saying with replacement. Right? With replacement. So 26, 26, 26. How many numbers do you have? From 0 to 9, it's 10. 10, 10. So there's it, with replacement. But they give us another condition. No vowels. How many vowels do we have? 5. A, E, I, O, U. Right. 5 vowels. So that means we cannot use vowels in the alphabet. So that means we don't have 26 options to choose from. We've got 21 options to choose from. And it's with replacement. And it's with replacement. So now we want to now calculate. So this is what we call the fundamental counting principle. We want to calculate how many different combinations are there. So all we do is we say 21 times 21 times 21 times 10 times 10 times 10. The fundamental counting principle. Let's see how many vehicles are there on Gauteng roads. 21 times 21 times times 21 times 10 times 10 times 10. Boom. We get 9,261,000 moving vehicles on number plates that can be allocated on Gauteng roads. 9,261,000 using the fundamental counting principle. Remember, this is the purpose of mathematics, guys. This is the purpose of our exercise. We're not just thumb-sucking values. We are now attaching exact values to situations so that we can calculate combinations mathematically. Okay? So that's what we have, the fundamental counting principle. Let's do one more example on the fundamental counting principle. And then we are done with this. Then we are going into factorials. And factorials is a big section. There's many different templates. There are many different ways. There are possibly about 8 to 10 different templates, 8 to 10 different styles in which factorials can be asked. So stay tuned to the show and pay attention. Okay, we're now on to the last example. And we say now, you're a restaurant owner. And you have a menu. And on your menu, you have starters. You've got main course. And you've got dessert on your menu. You've got four starters, right? Shrimp cocktail, prawn cocktail, baked potato, and okay, anything, whatever you want for starters, right? Let's now go on to your main. So you can have steak. Let's say you have steak, you have chicken, you have fish, and maybe you have prawns. So you've got four options here. Let's give you another one here. Maybe you've got another couple of options here. Desserts, you've only got three, right? You've got a tiramisu, you've got a black forest cake, and you've got something else. So now how many do we have here? So now you want to calculate, if you go into the restaurant, how many different combinations can you have, but provided it's in this order, starter, main course, dessert. We're not now mixing them all up. We're not saying that we're putting all the meals together and how many different ways can it be arranged. No, that is a factorial, right? We're now saying how many different combinations. So you could have, let's call this A, B, C, D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's call this X, Y, Z. Right. Now, you want to find out how many different combinations. So you could have starter A with main one. Starter A with main two. Starter A with main three. Starter A, main four, five, six, seven. You can have starter with a main and X dessert. Starter with a main and Y dessert. Starter, main one, Z dessert. That's first option. Your second option, right? Obviously, we're not going to do them for all. I'm just highlighting this. That is why we have this formula to help you to combinate without having to do all these things. Right. Then you've got, so now we're done with A. Let's go to B. You can go B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, B7. You can go B1X, B1Y, B1Z. You can go B2X, B2Y, A2X, A2Y, A2Z, A3X, A3. I think you're getting the picture of exactly what I'm telling you. So now you want to calculate, and this here is going to look like one big spider web when you're done. So there's no way you're going to be able to list all the different combinations. But you just want to calculate how many different combinations. Very simple, very simple. You've got four starters. You've got four starters. You've got seven main course, and you've got three desserts. So seven times four is 28. 28 times 3, 72? No, 84. 84. So you've got 84 different combinations that you could have from a menu having a starter first, a main second, and a dessert third. Okay? Stay tuned. We're cutting now for an ad break. I'll see you guys. You can take a little bit of a breather. Process whatever we've done. We've come to the end of the fundamental counting principle. When we get back into segment 3, we're starting with factorials. Stay tuned. Enjoy the show. Boys and girls, brothers and sisters, welcome back to the ITV Math Show. I hope you guys enjoying the show. We are in segment 3 of today's episode. Today's episode is episode 4 of probability. We're dealing with the fundamental counting principle and factorials. And this is a section that the grade 12s generally die in the exam. They leave it out. It's a huge topic, but it's only worth 15 marks in the exam. And we know it's unfair for the amount of effort that you need to put, for the amount of understanding, for the amount of practice, for the amount of stress. It's really not worth it. But unfortunately, you've got to do it. It's a dirty job and somebody's got to do it. Right. You're writing on it in the exam, so you have to know it. We ended up with the fundamental counting principle, and we did a variety of examples in our previous episode, in our previous segment. If you have missed any of the previous segments or episodes, please go on to itvnetworks.tv. Click onto the ITV Math Show. All the episodes will come. You can will appear. You can then view previous episodes, and it will then direct you into YouTube. And all our episodes are uploaded on YouTube. Okay, and for those of you who are using our DVDs, right, all these concepts are all explained on the DVDs. They are in detail. So please make sure those of you who are using the DVD, You use the DVD before the episode starts or immediately after the episode to reinforce the concepts that have been explained during the show. Okay, so let's go on. We're now done with the fundamental counting principle and now we're dealing with factorials. Now, what is the difference? Now, we said that fundamental counting principles talked about the number of combinations that you could possibly have, right? Okay, how many three-digit numbers can be made from 1 to 5? So you've got 5 options, 5 options, 5 options, 5 times 5 times 5 is 5 cubed, 125 different options. That is fundamental counting principle. We're now doing factorials and it says an arrangement of different objects in a definite order. I've given you an example. In how many different ways, here's it down, in how many different ways can the word ABC be arranged? So now we're not saying there are 26 here, there are 26 there, there are 26 letters there. We're now saying we are now focusing on a definite number of objects. We've got 3 objects, object A, object B, object C. Right, here goes. I've got a blue pen, I've got a red pen, and I've got a black pen. Right, let's put it black, blue, red. In how many different ways can these pens be arranged? I could have black, blue, red, black, red, blue. I could have red, black, blue. I could have blue, black, red. There are different combinations in which these 3 definite orders pens can be arranged. I've got A, B, C. I've got the letters A, B, C. And here we've listed them. We've listed them. It could be option 1, A, B, C. Option 2, A, C, B. You could have B, C, A. You could have B, A, C. You could have C, A, B. You could have C, B, A. How many options do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different options. Now, this is dealing with 3 items. What if you had 50 items? Are you now going to do 50 items and try and manipulate them all the time to find out how many different combinations can you have? No, you can't do it. That's why we call factorial. And factorials go right down to the number 1. Pay attention. Right, Mr. Cameraman, if you can just zoom in here. Factorials are multiplied right down to the number 1. Unlike the first one where we had 5 options, we said 5 times 5 times 5. We had no number 1. We didn't go 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Factorial goes right down to the number 1. That is the difference between a factorial and the fundamental counting principle. So now, if we want to do this, this is doing it physically. You want to now do it mathematically, right? So all you do now is, how many objects do you have? 1, 2, 3 objects. You say 3 objects times 2 objects times 1 object. So it will always go down. 3 times 2 times 1. It must go down to the number 1. So 3 times 2 is 6 times 1 is 6. And we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 options there. Whether we do it mathematically or whether we physically go and write out all the combinations, we must get exactly the same result. Now the factorial, basically, how do we write it in mathematics? We don't write it out 3 times 2 times 1. You could if you wanted to, or you could write it 3 factorial, the exclamation mark. Right, so for those of you who got the scientific calculator, you've got an exclamation, n exclamation, that is your permutation, or that is your, another word for factorials is permutation. Permutations mean how many different arrangements of different objects can you have in a definite order. Right, that is the meaning of the word permutation. So we go 3 factorial, and the 3 factorial, what does it represent? 3 times 2 times 1. If I had 5, okay, now let's go into examples, right? I'm going to take you from the most basic, which was this, up to the most advanced type that you could see in grade 12. There are probably about 5 or 6 different types. It gets a bit, it's very interesting. So if you stay focused, you'll be able to follow the train of thought right through until the end of the topic. Okay, so let's go on to the next example. Let's go on to the next example. And let's start with type 1. Alright, so get your books ready. Let's put type 1. And we'll start, we'll build on this example. So I'm going to give you one model, one template, and from here we're going to add on information and we're going to make it more complex and more deeper as we go along, right through until the end. Question number 1. In how many ways
can 7 books be arranged on a shelf? Answer. So that's a question. Very basic. In how many different ways can 7 books? So you could have 7 magazines. You could have the Men's Health. You could have the GQ. You could have the Fair Lady, Cosmopolitan, National Geographic, one mathematics textbook, and maybe a history book. Now you've got 7 different books. You want to know in how many different ways can you pack it on a shelf? You could have math, history, Cosmo, or you could have Cosmo, GQ, Men's Health, Women's Health at the end. You could then swap them all around. You want to know in how many different ways can those 7 books be arranged in a shelf, on a shelf? And that, guys, is a factorial, because it's a definite amount of books, 7 books only, right? So all we do is we say this is equal to 7 factorial, which we know is what? 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. It must go down to the number 1, because you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 spaces. You've got 7 spaces. 7 books will occupy 7 spaces on a shelf. That's why you go right down to the number 1. You multiply them all out, and I will give you the answer here already. We get 5,040 ways. There are 5,000. So from 7 books, there are 5,040 ways in which those 7 books can be arranged on a shelf. Okay? So this was type number 1. Let's now go into type 2. Let's now go into type 2. Now it says, let us suppose that we only want to arrange 4 of the 7 books. Right, so now we say, let's assume that we only want to arrange 4 of the 7 books. In how many ways can these 4 books be arranged? In how many ways can these books be arranged? So now it gets a little bit tricky, right? We've got 7 books, right? We're about to cut for an ad break. I want you to try and think about this during the break. Right, if you are in grade 12, you probably already know how to do it. But if you are using the logical approach, for those of you who haven't been introduced to the topic before, the post-school leavers, right, you can sit during this 3 minutes ad break and you can try and calculate. We only assume we have 7 books on the shelf, but only 4 of them need to be arranged. 4 out of the 7 books need to be arranged. In how many different ways can these 4 books be arranged? I'll see you in 3 minutes' time. عليها ليصبح همة ترضي عليها ليصبح همة. Boys and girls, welcome back to the ITV Math Show. I left you guys before the break with type 2, and we are doing factorials. Type 1 was, I asked you, in how many different ways can 7 books be arranged on a shelf? All you did is you did 7 factorial. You said 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, and you got an answer on your calculator as 5,040. Now we're going into type 2, and we are adjusting that scenario. We are now saying, let's assume that we only want to arrange 4 of the 7 books. In how many ways can these 4 books, okay, let's put it there, can these 4 books be arranged on the shelf? Okay, so only 4 of them need to be moved. In how many different ways can these 4 books be arranged? Now, very simple. I'm going to give it to you. Let's put it down this way. We take your total factorial, right? I know your teachers will give it to you as n factorial, your number factorial. I'm going to give it to you. Do not use this formula that I'm giving you exactly the way it is. It's just for your own understanding, right? You take the total factorial. I'm giving it to you in English so that you understand exactly what is going on when you are substituting. So you take total factorial over your total factorial over your total minus your target factorial. That's the way we do it. So what's your total factorial? How many books do you have? 7. So you go 7 factorial over, in brackets, what's your total factorial? 7 minus, what's your target factorial? How many books do you want to arrange? 4 factorial. So you go 7 factorial divided by 7 minus 4, which we know is 3. So it's 7 factorial over 3 factorial. And 7 factorial over 3 factorial. Let us check what is the answer to that. And you will get 840 ways. Okay, there are 840 ways in which from 5,040 different combinations, if only 4 books need to be arranged in different ways, we then take our total factorial divided by, in brackets, your total minus your target factorial, and you get 7 factorial over 3 factorial, you get 840 different ways in which those books can be arranged. Okay, now let's see. What happens? Now we're going on to type 3, so I hope you understand that. In fact, you guys want to do one more example of this? Let's do one more example of this, right? Let's put it this way. We're still on type 2. I'm just doing another example so that you understand. I'm going to leave this because that's the way, that is a strategy, that is a structure in which you're going to answer it. Right. In how many ways can 3 boys be selected from 10 boys? Assume we have 10 boys. We want to now select 3 boys from the group of 10 boys. In how many different ways can we choose? Oh, we've got 10 names, 10 boys' names. We need to choose 3 names. How many different combinations of 3 boys' names will we have from a group or from a pool of 10 boys? And this is the formula that we're going to use. Our total over your total minus your target. So you've got 10 boys, 10 factorial over 10 minus 3 minus your target factorial. Exactly what we did. I copy and paste. It's the same system, factorial. So we've got here, and your answer here is 720 ways. And that's your answer, right? You've got 720 ways of choosing 3 boys from a group of 10 boys. All right, so that was type 2. We just did another example of type 2. We're now going into type 3. Now, guys, this is the last segment of today's show, right? Remember, this is going to continue into the next show too. So we will wrap probability up. Definitely not in today's show. One more show and we are done with probability. Okay, now comes, what happens if some of the objects are identical? Now we have, let's put here, identical items. Okay, let's do that. Here's an example of it. In how many different ways can the letters of the word Mpumalanga be arranged? In how many ways can the letters of the word Mpumalanga be arranged? Question, answer. And I know you've seen this in the exam, right? So we can choose any, whether you are living in Johannesburg, whether you are living in any town, you want it, or you take any word and you want to find out in how many different ways. Take your own name, for example. Take your own name. In how many different ways can those letters in your own name be arranged? Okay, so how many letters do we have? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Right? So basically, what do we have? When we are calculating the... We take our total factorial. So this is the way we do it. I'm giving it to you in English. So this is a strategy again. I'm giving it to you in English. So we take our total divided by your repetitions factorial times your repetition factorial times your repetition factorial times blah, blah, blah. Depending on how many letters are repeated. depending on how many liters. So basically the mathematics formula for this is n factorial over p factorial times q factorial times r factorial times dot 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 going on to infinity, depending on the number of repetitions do you have. I've just converted this to English so it makes it easy for you to understand. So you take your total factorial divided by how many letters are being repeated. So let's do it. We take our total factorial. Our total factorial here, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it's going to be 10 factorial over. Which letters are repeated? Right, the M, we only got one M. P, one P. U, one U. No, M's, we got two. We got two M's. So we can go 2 factorial times anything else? Yes, we've got an A, we've got an A, we got an A times 3 factorial. And there we go, your total factorial, because there are two m's, I'm just going to put the m's here small. You won't write this in the exam, right? This is just to show you where I got the 2 from. And where did I get the 3 from? Because we had the a's. And we put multiply. So it's 10 factorial divided by 2 factorial times 3 factorial. The answer that you should get there is 302,400 ways. There are 302,000 different ways in which the word Mpumalanga can be arranged. Let's do another example. Let's see if you can do this. If you're a parent sitting at home and you got your pen and paper, I know many of you have already got your exam pads out and you're already working. Getting that brain juices working at the age of 65 and 70 is the best thing that you can do in the world. Right, let's now change this over and let's do another example that looks exactly like this. Take out your calculators. In how many different ways can the word Namakwalan be arranged? The word, let's choose another word, Namakwalan. Now we're using all these areas in South Africa for our international viewers, right? Namakwalan is an area, Mpumalanga is a province in South Africa. When you guys do happen to visit South Africa, beautiful place, best place in the world. I'd never leave this country for anything else, despite whatever the bad publicity and the bad media that has been exposed to the world. Yeah, well, crime is in every country in the world, but yes, we are still a world-class African city. South Africa, best place in the world, right? And I'm not just saying it. Come to South Africa, view our place, and then you'll know what you're missing. Okay, right. In how many different ways can the letters of the word Namakwalan be? So we said total factorial divided by your number of repetitions. The product of your number of repetitions. So what do we have? We've got one N, Namakwalan. Okay, let's first see our total. How many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We've got 11 letters, so it's 11 factorial over. The letter N appears twice. Namakwalan, 2 factorial times. Anything else? Yes, we've got A's. 1, 2, 3, 4 factorial times 4 factorial. Is that all? Yes. M's, we've got 1. K, we've got 1. W, we've got 1. L, we've got 1. D, we've got 1. So your total, your answer there will be 11 factorial over 2 factorial times. And your final answer there, let's just go here, let's just check here. Namakwalan, 831,600. 831,600 ways. And if you got this answer, you know you are right. So the letters of the word Namakwalan can be arranged in 831,600 ways. What is the probability that if all these letters, now we come to probability, we're almost at the end of the show, guys. What is the probability of the event that you take all these alphabets on Scrabble letters? You know the game Scrabble? You take the words Namakwalan out, they're all individual letters, you put them in a bag, you shake the bag. What is the probability that when you take out all the letters one by one, that the word is going to spell Namakwalan? What is that probability? That probability is one event out of 831,600 different ways. Okay, and that's how we bring in probability with factorials. Right, it's always probability is one out of the total option. Okay, guys, we've come to the end of today's show. Remember, this is not the end of factorials. We will carry on into episode 5.
which will then wrap up the probability component for all our grade 12s who are busy writing for 2015. Good luck from us here in studio with our cameraman, Mr. Fidel, Peter, Yusuf, everyone here in studio. Thumbs up for you guys doing a fantastic job here in studio. Hope you guys are enjoying the show as much as we are enjoying it here in studio. For me, Mohammed Kota, your presenter and host, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الأمجاد قد عظمت فللأمجاد بانيها ومن يسعى إلى العليا سيدركها بما فيها ويبني مجده جذلا فروح الفذ يعليها ليصبح همة تروي عن العليا مغنيها.